How you feeling?
Ontario Provincial Police say two teen girls who were lost in Algonquin Park for 3 days did exactly what they were supposed to do, stayed close to where they went off the trail. They say that is why the search was successful and the two girls were located yesterday afternoon. And they say it's one of the most important pieces of advice if you're heading out into the wilderness. But there are five other must-haves if you're heading out to remote areas to canoe or hike.
Mm-hmm. What are the main things we have to keep in mind?
Some pretty essential things. Even though it might be a day like this where it looks like it's not going to rain, you want to take with you some rain gear. A raincoat and some rain pants. And that's just being ready for whatever the environment might have to throw at you. And then if you are misplaced or a little off track, at least you know you're ready for whatever might come your way.
Things can change.
Things can change, yes. And then with that, a nice fleece layer. We don't know what the temperature is going to be at night necessarily. It might drop quite a bit, especially if you're a little bit farther north. Even here in the city, so when we send people out in the summer, we ask them to bring toques and layers with them, which sometimes maybe even long johns might be a bit of a surprise. So food and water, always being ready for being out for maybe an undetermined amount of time. So being ready to keep yourself hydrated, especially in the hot weather, and then having a snack, having some food on hand, maybe a little bit more than you think you might need.
How much should you have on you at any given point?
I mean, it depends on how long you're going out for. Having an extra day of rations is not a bad idea. Map and compass is a pretty common way of navigating in the wilderness. There's also some areas where you're at Algonquin Park, say, perhaps, and very close to a base camp, and just knowing what lake you're on. So knowing where you're going to go, knowing where the emergency access routes are, roads, things like that. And then with that also was a whistle in case you do get off track. The sound of a whistle can carry quite far, so hopefully it will reach somebody else in your area. Three sustained blows is the sign for an emergency, so that means something is going on and I need help.
If you do get lost, what should you do?
Stay put. Hopefully somebody knows where you are. You've told them that in advance. Hopefully you have a whistle and you can give it a blast and then somebody around you will come and find you.
Why is it important to stay there and not try to find your way back?
Because chances are if you've told someone where you are and you haven't come back on time, they're looking for you already. So they might be out there themselves taking a look around, or they might be asking some volunteers or the local emergency resources. And if they're looking for you and you're continuing to move, then they may not circle around to where you are at the right times.
It is also recommended that if you are going to be heading out into the wilderness, that you take a survival course. There are several available across the country. Audra Brown, City News.